Welcome, everybody. Today, we have the great honor to interview Professor Akira Matsumura, President of the Ibaraki Prefectural University of Health Sciences in Japan and Vice President of the International Society for Neutron Capture Therapy. My name is Valeria Monti, and I'm here with Naonori Ko. We are both members of the International Society for Neutron Capture Therapy. So hello, Naonori. Good evening, Professor Matsumura. Thank you for being here and for participating to this interview. I would like to start with a simple question. Can you describe your career briefly? How and when did you start to be involved in BNCT research?
Yes, thank you for your question. I'm glad to have interview with you. I'm really looking forward to speak with you. So I graduated from the University of Tsukuba in 1980, very old age. And I started with a neurosurgery. And I practiced also neurosurgery in Germany, in Göttingen, and also in London, England, and then came back to Japan. And in 1992, I became assistant professor at my University of Tsukuba, and then started to join Professor Hatanaka's clinical research, which was done at the JRR2 at the JERI in Tokai Village. So, and then I attended the ISNCT from the 6th ISNCT in 1994 in Kobe. Then I continued to participate in this INCT. And I also organized the 15th INCT in Tsukuba in 2012, as you may know. So that's my brief career.
Thank you very much. It has been really a great and fruitful career. Among your various professional experiences, you were leader of the IBNCT project. Can you tell us briefly about this project?
Yes. We have started our IBNCT. I stands for Ibaraki Prefecture, so, and also intelligent. So we started this project in 2011 with the University of Tsukuba and also the High Energy Accelerator Research Organization, so-called KEK, and also Japan Atomic Energy Agency, JAEA. And it was initially very small spontaneous research group, but then luckily we were chosen as a national project from the Japanese government, which started to promote innovative technique in Japan. So we were able to build up accelerator with the ideal performance, especially for BNCT. And it was rather hard time since the requirement of the accelerator was very high. But finally, we are now reaching the desired performance and now planning to start clinical trials for the cancer patient soon. So that was the IBNCT.
It's really a great result.
Yes, thank you. So I will like to ask the next questions. So Japan is probably the country in which BNCT is largely sort of spread out. Can you give us an overview of the Japanese BNCT state of the art and how many centers are currently treating patients and how many are upcoming?
Yes, at the moment in Japan, two hospitals are running clinically approved medical BNCT, namely the Southern Tohoku Hospital in Koriyama, and the other one is Osaka Medical College. Yeah. And they are now treating recurrent head and neck cancers. And I think, they're treating several patients per week. And I think it has been not been spread yet, but I think the number of the patients will increase if the it will be recognized from the other medical specialists. And I think the clinical trial for recurrent malignant brain tumor such as glioblastoma has been finished by Professor Miyatake, and they are now trying to make approval to the PMDA. So it will become, I think, soon. And also for malignant meningioma, which is a kind of brain tumor, Professor Miyatake is now performing a clinical trial to be recognized as a medical treatment by PMDA. So now there are several clinical trials going on at the Osaka Medical College. And the other thing is at the National Cancer Institute in Tokyo, they have also started the clinical trial for approval, to get approval for the skin melanoma and also vascular sarcoma. And I've heard that they have quite good results at the moment, but they have to collect more patients and then make approval by PMDA. So I think there are several trials now. And our machine at Tokai is now starting the preclinical trial to go into the clinical phase. And we hope that we can soon jump into the clinical trial soon. So, and finally, our goal in Japan is probably to expand the number of the BNCT treatment facilities in Japan, maybe similar to Proton Center, which we have 17 centers in Japan, or hopefully more. That's my hope.
Yes, thank you very much. Yes, it's certainly expanding very slowly, but certainly, and we would love to see more and more centers coming up. So throughout your long career in BNCT, what has been the greatest satisfaction that the work on BNCT has given you? And if any, were there any sort of difficult times in BNCT in your career?
Yeah, we have always happy and sad times, but the most, great satisfaction is that we could now have an accelerator for BNCT. As I started with a nuclear reactor, it was some kind of dream. But after the techniques for the accelerator has been developed, it became as a real world. So now I'm very happy, and also I'm very happy that other colleagues like Sumitomo Heavy Industrial or NT company has also succeeded to create such medical accelerators. And my difficult times, it was when I started in 1992, I did clinical research work with Professor Hatanaka, and also did some basic experiments at KUR. But at that time, there were a big against movement to BNCT. So we were like lonely wolves in our field. Many causes. First, it was because the BNCT were performed in various research reactors with the various protocols, and we couldn't get proven clinical data. It was very difficult to do some randomized controlled trials at the research reactor, because research reactor always stops, and we couldn't get so many patients, and we couldn't get the control data and so on. So it was a very hard time. But then after having this epithermal beam, we could gain the number of patients. And also we had a so kind of a good group in the ISNCT. So it became a global movement. So after Japan was a lonely wolf, ISNCT had a big contribution to spread ENCT into the world. Yeah, and always difficult times. One of the issues is that I propose that to revise the IA Tech Talk in 2010 in Buenos Aires meeting. And I was responsible for this team. But and when I went to IAEA in 2010 or 11, as a lonely wolf, there was a great headwind against the BNCT in IAEA. So, but in 2011, there was one guy from IAEA came to ICRR in Warsaw, and we had a meeting with Dr. Neev and Mandy. And then we started to make some forum on the IAEA webpage and to start to promote the revision of TEPCO. But then, because the person of IAEA possibly left IAEA, there was no movement after that. But after that, Okayama University and IAEA made a MOU, and then it restarted again to make a big movement. And now, in the present status, as you know, the Tech Talk revision is now going on. I think it's a very big movement, and I am very happy about this. And I'm looking forward to see the next revised IA Tech Talk.
Thank you very much for this comment. It's very interesting. It seems to me now we are in an historical moment, as also you said, in which BNCT is going to spread across different continents, so Europe, USA. So what do you see in future for BNCT in Japan and all around the world?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I give you one example. We started our proton beam treatment at KEK. It was just one port from a big, huge accelerator. And it was experimental clinical research. And it took, and we started in 1983, and it took 17 years until we got the medical proton beam facility in 2000 at our University of Tsukuba Hospital. So it took 17 years. But after that, it took 16 years to get the health insurance coverage from Japanese Ministry of Health. So like this example, if you want to make a totally new treatment, it will take time, sometimes decade or decades. So I think now, as you mentioned, it's now a big turn. So we have to concentrate how to make BNCT in the real medical world. For that purpose, the Japanese government also made a special fast-track method to approve BNCT as a medical treatment by the Sumitomo Heavy Industrial Machine. I think it's a big movement. And not to lose such movement, I think we have to collaborate internationally and make a strong team to enhance this BNCT method all over the world. So don't keep in individual groups, but we have make a interdisciplinary team to expand this activity, I think.
Thank you very much. And I move to the next question. In your opinion, what are some of the obstacles that we need to overcome to spread BNCT?
Whether it's an obstacle or some future project is, we have now only BPA as a medical drug for BNCT. I think BPA is a quite good drug, and we have also good experience with BPA. But the next obstacles or next project would be to make a more effective drug compared to BPA. And then we will have more treatment effect for BMCT. And so for that purpose, I think one of the obstacles is to make a standard drug for the next generation BMCT. And for example, for the drug, we have the International Council for Harmonization of Technical Requirements for Pharmaceuticals for Human Use, the so-called ICH, so an international harmonization of the drug development. But in BMCT, we don't have such a kind of group approach yet. But in the future, we have to do similar approach like ICH to have a to establish the standard for the drug development for BMCT in the world. Otherwise, each country has its own regulation, and we cannot use the drug in other countries. So we have to make a similar approach to that. And for that purpose, INCT is a very important society, and IA as well. And so we have to deal with the ISNCT, IA, or maybe to PTCOG and other radiation societies to enhance this obstacle.
Thank you. I would like to know your opinion about what makes BNCT so attractive and interesting, both from the medical point of view and from the scientific one.
Yeah, first, from the scientific view, BNCT is a really interdisciplinary field, so that many field from the many researchers from various fields come together and discuss about the progress for BMCT. For example, I am a medical physician, but I talk with a physicist, chemist, pharmacologist, biologist, and so on. And we have a very good friendship. And not so many areas in medical field like the BMCT could we enhance the collaboration with the interdisciplinary team. That's one, I like this atmosphere very much. And from the clinical point of view, I'm a neurosurgeon, neuro-oncologist, and I have seen many type of treatments. But I think BMCT is the only radiation technique which can focus on each cellular level. Radiation therapy is doing some physical field radiation, but the BNCT is on the cellular level. And it's like, it's similar to chemotherapy, but not toxic, not so systemically toxic as chemotherapy. So I think BNCT is very good in treating cellular level with a very high damage using alpha particle. I think it's a very unique treatment. So that's why I'm selecting BNCT as my life work. And after that, to say that, I think the attractive point is, now we have a medical accelerator by the big effort from the physicists. So we have the machine. But in the future, there is a bright future, because the research for medical drugs are always progressing. So we have a molecular targeting, gene therapy, and also some targeting therapy, and so on. And once we have a machine, the neutron source, the drug, when we have a drug development, we can enhance the effect of BMCT. On the other hand, like other radiation therapy, they have only the physical effect only. So there is no big progress like BNCT. I think it's a most attractive point of BNCT in research as well in clinical field.
Thank you very much. It's a very interesting point of view.
Yes, very, very interesting. Thank you. And sort of following on, sort of, it's a very, very interesting field. What is your suggestion for young scientists that have the desire to start working in BNCT?
Yes, thank you very much for this question. I always say to my younger colleagues, if you stick to one issue for decades or decades, you will become an expert in this field. But so keep going to involve in this attractive field. So keep going. And do not follow any fashion too much. Because since if something is in some good trends, then if you jump in, it's too late to become the leader of this corresponding field in many fields. So BNCT is a still young research field. But if you continue to work in BNCT, you become a big boss in several years or decades. So I myself also involved in BNCT in 1992. At that time was a very, we were a lonely wolf. But now we became, I didn't become a big boss, but I still continue to work on BNCT, and I'm very happy about the progress of BNCT. So I recommend the young people, scientists, to keep on going and don't lose your interest to BNCT.
Yes, thank you very much for your wise words. And so the next question, is there any piece of advice you can give to countries who are going to start BNCT?
At the moment, I think Japan and Taiwan and Finland is doing clinical trials or clinical treatment of BNCT. But besides these countries, there are not so much countries where the clinicians are involved in the BNCT research or clinical work. And I think more clinicians should be involved in BNCT because the goal of the BNCT is to treat the patients. So unless the clinicians doesn't have interest in BNCT, I think the activity of BNCT do not spread in these countries. So my one of my suggestion, and we talk in there also in the Japanese Society of Neutron Capture Therapy, that we could invite clinicians from various countries who do not have experience in BNCT and show the clinical procedure of BNCT and also the clinical effect of BNCT so that these clinicians would have a great impact and also interest in BNCT. And the final goal is to treat the BNCT patients. So that we should keep concentrating to recruit more clinicians to this field to develop BNCT as a medical treatment.
Yes, that's a very valid point you mentioned about getting the doctors on board, and it's a very great idea to have them come and visit a center that are actually doing BNCT. So I think that's a great idea. As the vice president of the ISNCT, as we have also asked Ignacio and Sylvia, we would like to know what you think the role of the ISNCT should be.
Yes. In the earlier times, ISNCT was a very small group with the researchers who were interested in BNCT. It was a kind of good friends, I think. But when accelerator became evident, we have to change the society as a strategic society. So I propose that the Missouri, in, I think 2016, to change the formation of executive committee, and executive board should be selected from each technical committee, and also these executive board should report the progress of each technical meeting to the executive board and also to the society, so that we can share all the information from the physics, biology, clinical, and so on. And this was approved in Taiwan in 2018. And now Ignacio is doing a very good job towards the IAEA, and he has a good communication skill, and also Silva makes a very good job to strengthen ISMCT. And recently, I think PT Cog also showed some interest to ISMCT, and also IAEA as well. And I think Ignacio is doing a good job to make ISMCT as a strong society, as a strategic society, to make BNCT in a, as a real medical treatment. So in the future, we should also make this society more stronger, so that our presence will be recognized from other societies, and we can put BNCT into the real medical world.
Thank you very much. So last question, you already touched on this, but in your opinion, how important is the exchange of information between different countries and different research groups?
Yes, very good question. I think each country has its own regulation, culture, and also other customs. But we, in the academic society, we should have one language that we can speak and stay on same platform. For that purpose, I think we have to understand the difference of the situation of each country, but also based on this difference, we may make to have a one standard or same platform to be able to discuss in the same manner. And I think TikTok is one of the good samples. So by using TikTok, we have a one standard, and we can discuss or talk based on this standard. So the IAEA standard is very important. And one other thing, as I said, the clinical protocol or dose description or Boron dose description should be also in the same platform, because when you say boron in concentration 30 or 35, and if the method is different, might be different. But we have, as a globalization, we have to have a one same platform to be that we can measure the, for example, boron concentration or boron dose or something like that. That is now going on the based on the IA TikTok discussion, and I think we should have more exchange to make these research groups and different countries on the same platform.
Thank you very much. Let's hope in the future the collaboration will be more and more strong. So thank you very much, Professor Matsumura. I think it was a very nice conversation, full of interesting points of view. And so thank you again for participating to the interview. And thank you, Naonori, for conducting the interview with me.
Thank you.
Thank you all for watching. And see you next video.
So see you.
Thank you very much.